So let's look at the working agreement. This is outside of a Scrum framework, but working agreement is used by a lot of team members. And just like it sounds like, working agreement is, when we work in a team, what are some of the rules?
What's the expectations?
Yeah, what are the expectations? Those are some of the things that needs to be there, explicitly there, for where everybody can get access to it. So we all know that this is a multiplayer game. There are some agreements there, so everybody can play together and nobody's mad or nobody's unheard, so we can make that very explicit for the team.
Yeah, and I think a lot of that came up because we're collaborating as a team, right? There's no manager, project manager, dictating, hey, you gotta get your stuff done, why don't you get your stuff done? Hey, you didn't get your stuff done.
Yeah.
It's not that, it's a collaboration. So everybody needs to say, yes, I agree to what the team is saying and I can do my part to make that happen.
Yeah.
And so it's important. When I actually started at a company and they had that, I had always thought before that they're pretty frivolous. But when I worked into a new team that they had been working on a project for over a year, they had the working agreement, magneted up to their whiteboard. When I walked in the room, one of the first things they said is they'd read this. And I read it and it was a one-page document, but it talked a lot about what they were looking to accomplish and what the expectations were for people that were part of that team.
Yeah.
And it was like, it was really just looking, here's what we expect of you as a team member.
And you know, a lot of the times there's a lot of challenges happening in the team because there are a lot of assumed and not talked about agreements, right? This should happen, but why haven't you talked about it, right?
Yep.
So this is actually, even if somebody doesn't agree to an agreement, this allows for a conversation so that everybody's voice is heard. And now we know, if, like, you know, for example, a developer said to me, is like, I don't like being interrupted. And if you're gonna come and actually ask me a question, please ping me that you're coming, because I literally get scared if you come. So now we all agree that, hey, we're not gonna just go and say, hey, how's it going? Because that's important for that team member. It is a living document where it's available to everybody. And it's also a changing document. If something, some agreement doesn't work out for the team, then that can change. For example, you know, we had a working agreement that our working hours were from 8 to 5, and summertime happened, and one of the developers had to drop the kids in the school in the morning.
Oh, sure, yep. So they're a little late.
Yeah, so we just changed literally from 8 o'clock to 9:30, and then we moved our stand-up, and it was as simple as having the agreement. Instead of this person showing up late in the stand-up, we just talked about it and we just update our working agreement.
You guys are on one team going towards one goal, work together,
100%.
Right?
So that is the essence of working agreement.
So for students, the working agreement, you're gonna find it in a lot of different organizations. It's not required by any means, and it's not even part of Scrum, but a lot of companies and a lot of organizations have picked it up to help them solve some of those problems before they become problems,
100%.
Really get ahead of everything.
100%.